to the day I die. Muggy PNG, let the knocker fly. Be looking one plamana, emusa. I'm like I'm loyal, and by you asking why. If he wants the air value, then your boy obliged. But if his interest in his pockets, then I can't comply. And if he wants to board the plane, let the man decide. But when your man arrives, he best be sanctified. Because the jungle gon' decide if the man survives. And that's my observation, you can call it what you want. And if you got a problem with it, you gon' change that shit. Hey, you walking at my door with complaints, ain't it? You got feels with your people, go contain that shit. Or go and solve it in a way that don't involve payment. Cause it's a plaster on the wound, sending monkeys to the moon. An expense and excuse, trying to find a couple clues. I prefer to heed advice from the master of the woman. In my class or my room, glad to see you skip school, man. And this is a consequence, I don't wanna hear from you messing with that nonsense.
If it can be helped, I hope, I hope. You do everything to protect our home. I know my soul is so crazy to think some people don't care. I like my sky blue and the ocean clear. This side of the grass, they green. That side filled with too much greed, I do not need.
Said if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Cause we don't know what we got till it's gone. And then miss it, already misjudged for the pigment. Remember to always stay true to your roots and uplift it. Elevate your voice, middle finger to the system. When they treat nature like it's fiction, berate you for lowering emissions of carbon, but starving the kids of the wisdom. When Father Time and Mother Nature speak, listen. Gonna try their best to oppress us, never giving in till I rest up. Been lied to for so long, the truth is next up. Stay in tune, cause some cats funny, no Sylvester. No different from the rest of the colonized tribes. Still have their land stolen in these modernized times, corrupted like puppets. But one day they'll have their comeuppance and justice for these horrifying crimes.
If it can be helped, I hope, I hope. You do everything to protect our home. I know it's so, so crazy to think some people don't care. I like my sky blue and the ocean clear. This side of the grass stay green. That side filled with too much greed, I do not need no.
If I could, I swear I would. I'm good for it, you know I am. I know Papa knows my plans and sabe. All the knockers to the side, merito que sabe. Em la loca mi lo fran. Now you like killing me, that's my babe. But me make it one block cool. Papa dance my rapid. Some pro boys in style. But you get some block money. If not, ever killing me. Now by me die, support me, let's die. Get up, now by me going high. Mona got a pain, I'm not go. Ingi lungo, ain't got very stop. Now y'all already know.
Romeo, me lose me penis. Me lose me susu. Me go over to your same mangi. Now me go over to come at him, Papa Blomina. Me look him whip a man. Me look him, me no look straight. Me plant no good true. Now me go cry cry cry.
Well, we never kill people to go and look for gold, or we never kill them because they tried to stop us from looking for gold. The only reason we kill people was simply if we had to kill them, they would have killed us and all our carriers, all the people that we were with. The gold had nothing to do with it.
Guinea was one of the last places on earth to be colonized by Europeans. In the 1920s, the Australians occupied only the coastal fringe of this huge island lying just to their north. Of the interior, nothing was known. No European had ever been there. Australia, the occupying colonial power, saw its role as bringing civilization to New Guinea. Along the coast, missionaries busied themselves saving souls, while the plantation owners put them to work. It was cheap labor. But by the mid-1920s, New Guinea was hard hit by low world prices for its few products. There seemed little to attract the white man. And then, in 1926, gold was discovered a mere 40 miles inland. Hundreds of Australians came up to New Guinea in search of the quick fortune.
The great day has arrived. Dredge number one is completed and ready for work. The official opening is an occasion for celebration and festivities. The floating monster's arrival from civilization thrills the Kanaka as much as the white man, and he throws himself into his task with zest. You will understand how the native has benefited by these activities. A long time will elapse before he shakes off the shackles of barbarism, but his contact with the environment of the white man must inevitably hasten his progress along the path that leads to civilization.